Well, let's go straight to our top story tonight. The much talked about cabinet reshuffle, which we've been hearing about for months, is finally taking place tomorrow at 5 p.m. Sources say that the big portfolios of home, finance, defense and external affairs are unlikely to be touched. 6 to 7 new faces are expected to be inducted, while some ministers may get a promotion as well. Rahul Srivastav has more on that big story. Rahul, at the end of the day, it doesn't seem to be a major reshuffle, but not minor either. Where would you place it?
Perhaps one can very clearly say that if the Prime Minister had gone in for a major reshuffle, it would have been a brave move. But perhaps right now this is a beleaguered government. And what we are hearing from the government sources is that the Council of Ministers basically needed, in terms of change, 3 basic elements. One was reinvention, the second was restructuring, and third was replacement. Perhaps reinvention is extremely difficult, though we are hearing that one of the top ministers has perhaps conveyed to the top echelons in the Congress that he would like change from his ministry. But perhaps that's not going to happen. Perhaps because, one, the session is approaching, and also the kind of build-up that one needed for a new cabinet to take on the opposition and various other charges and the troubles, the Prime Minister would perhaps feel safer if he has the top 4 with him. Perhaps beyond that, there are larger numbers, it seems, which are going to be rotated. What we are also hearing, that people like Mr. Kapil Sibal, who are holding 2 portfolios, might lose one of them. Then there might be perhaps change to get their replacement for them. But it's going to be an exercise at restructuring. Perhaps from Assam, for example, people have done, Congress has done better. One minister might be added to perhaps pole-bound states. Ministers from Uttar Pradesh might come in. The Congress would like to send a signal. DMK is not getting anybody. Perhaps that's what one very strong signal. Also importantly, there are going to be elevations for Dinesh Trivedi to railways, Gurudas Kamath, Sudeep Bandopadhyay, Jyotiraditya Sindhya, Milind Deora, and several others. 12 to 13 odd chairs have been fixed inside the Darbar pressing out for the swearing in. One will have to wait and see who will be sitting on them.
All right. Never envy those who have to cover a cabinet reshuffle. Thanks very much for that, Rahul. And that brings us to our first question tonight. Will cosmetic changes be enough? If that is what it does turn out to be tomorrow, do tell us what you think. Well, joining us on the program tonight, we have the Congress spokesperson, Dr. Abhishek Singhvi. We have the chief spokesperson of the BJP, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. From Mumbai, we're joined by the national secretary of the CPI, Mr. D. Raja. And we have the political editor of the Hindustan Times, Mr. Vinod Sharma, here in the studio with me. I'll ask Mr. Vinod Sharma first, because actually it's only the Prime Minister and Mrs. Gandhi who probably know who's in and who's out tomorrow. Okay. But I heard the list is in your pocket. No. So what are you hearing?
No, I wouldn't claim that, and it's not true. But I can only make an intelligent guess. 2-3 things which are almost certain, perhaps, is that Dinesh Trivedi shall be the new Minister for Railways. And Beni Prasad Varma, who's from Uttar Pradesh, a very prominent Kurmi leader, who was unhappy last time for having been made Minister of State despite having been Cabinet Minister earlier, may get an elevation as Cabinet Minister, full Cabinet Minister. Similarly, I've heard that Shrikant Jaina, who again was a Minister of State who had earlier been in Cabinet, full Cabinet Minister
also
during
Gowda's
government, could get an elevation.
So the
as
big
Minister
four,
of State
you're
for
also hearing are not being touched,
charge.
The big four.
Well, doesn't look like that these big four will be touched, though there was a thinking that Mr. S.M. Krishna, PM could do with replacing S.M. Krishna, but they perhaps did not have a good replacement for him. Although we heard the names of Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad as Minister for External Affairs, it would have been a nice political move having a Kashmiri Muslim as External Affairs Minister. Internationally, it would have been a good move.
Well, Mr. Krishna is having a press conference day after tomorrow
yes.
morning, which I think shows he's fairly
but
confident
Moily,
he's not going
but
anywhere.
But Mr. Moily has cancelled a foreign trip.
Yeah.
Which raises questions about his longevity.
Let me ask Abhishek Singhvi. Of course, I know what your answer will be. Dr. Singhvi, you will say that it's the Prime Minister's prerogative. It's not for us to debate in TV studios about what the cabinet could look like. But my question is this, that, you know, if the big four are not touched in this reshuffle, then does it, in a sense, become a little bit pointless? Because the Prime Minister did a sort of minor reshuffle earlier this year. Then he said it would be more expansive later this year. It's taken several months to come to this. There's been all kinds of guessing games that have taken place in the run-up to this reshuffle. It's really been long pending. So if those big four portfolios aren't touched, is it a bit of a dampener?
It is a dampener for sensational television programs. It is a dampener for gossip and newspapers. Of course it is. And I must admire and salute your persistence that knowing the answer I'm going to give, you still have programs. Well, obviously, you know, Nidhi, cabinet reshuffles are decided elsewhere. And I always joke, I say, really only two people know. And those two are not talking. And everybody else is speculating. So this is part of the game. I think this is good to keep the newspaper mills churning. The 24/7 channels have to have masala all the time, but nothing more than that. Number two, I think these are truly, you know, decisions taken on so many considerations, and we tend to be a little superficial when we discuss them like this. I mean, why should the Big Four be changed? I'm not saying they're going to be changed or not being changed, but I'm just answering your question by asking myself. I mean, by definition, they are supposed to be the Big Four. They're supposed to be the arc of the government. Should they be changed just because it creates more fun and ripple for the opposition?
NDTV's cricket app. Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard. Special analysis. And much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.